Hi everyone, this is a tutorial how to make this, how to connect these flowers, and you can make so many things from them. I will show how to crochet these flowers and also how to connect them. You can make so many things from them. You can make a blanket, you can make a mat or rug or pillowcase. In other tutorials, I will show other ways how to connect this, but this is using this simple stitch, you can connect them. And also I will go through how to crochet them. Let's get started. So for this, I'm using weight 4 yarn. Let's make a slip knot. Chain 5. Now we'll connect into a circle, insert into the first chain. We'll hold that tail close to the circle and now just pull up this loop. So yarn over and we'll go into that middle 4 times. So we have already one loop, so the first one will go 3 times and the for the rest will go 4 times. Okay, so we have one loop, 2, and now yarn over into the middle, 3, yarn over, and one more time, 4. Hold that yarn and pull through. Now come back between the loop and the yarn, insert here, yarn over and pull through this stitch right here. Chain 2. We repeat again and we'll go into that middle 4 times. So yarn over and into the middle 1, pull up. Yarn over into the middle 2, yarn over into the middle 3, and last time 4. Now hold that yarn and pull through all of the loops and that stitch. Come back into that space between the loops and the yarn, yarn over, pull through and pull through. And repeat, chain 2. And we repeat with yarn over and into the middle 1, 2, 3, one more time 4. Hold that yarn, pull through everything, come back between the yarn and the loops. Pull through and pull through. So we have 3. 1, 2, 3. We'll go with 6. We'll make 6 petals. So chain 2. And we'll make 3 more. Into that middle. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, and 4. Hold it, pull through, come back into that space, yarn over, pull and pull. We have 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, chain 2, and we'll go with, we need 2 more petals. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, and 4. Pull that. Come back. Here we go. And we need one more, the last one. Chain 2. And this is going to be the last one into that middle. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Hold that yarn, pull through this, and then like this, chain 2, and now we'll connect under 2 strands here, pull through with a slip stitch like this. Okay, so just and pull through. Now we'll take a large needle a little bit. And we just can remove that from the middle. Okay, so we have 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 petals, and make more flowers like this. One more just to show how another way to make it. I have thin yarn, as this is much thinner than 4, so I'm taking 2 strands. So if you have anything with thinner yarn, you can use 2 strands. It's going to be the same way, except this is 2 strands. So chain 5. And we connect into a circle. Everything will be the same, except we will be working with 2 strands into a circle. Now we'll pull up this loop and yarn over and go 3 times with for the first petal. So 2, 3, and 4. Now we hold that yarn and go through, come back between the yarn and the loop, and pull through. We chain 2, and now we'll repeat, yarn over into a circle 4 times. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Hold that yarn and pull through everything. Come back between the yarn and the loops, yarn over and pull through. Chain 2. And we work on another petal the same way. And go 1, 2, 3, and 4. Go like, come back, yarn over and pull through. And just walk like this, chain 2, and make 3 more petals. So we have 3, work on 3 additional. I have 5 petals, and this is my last one, 6. Now chain 2 to finish, insert under 2 strands, and join with a slip stitch. And just hide the ends. There are so many projects that you can create from these flowers. You can create a pillowcase, you can create a mat or rug, also you can create a blanket. So we'll take two flowers, both this is good side and this one is good side, that side. So good side into middle, and we'll insert the hook into that space of one flower and another, taking two strands and make a stitch. We'll hide the ends and secure later, and we'll go with, so that was one stitch, this is two, and one more time, three. We'll secure later. Now I'm taking another flower, good side, connecting with this, facing that one, good facing good side, insert into the next space and this flower, and making three single crochet, one, two, and three. And I'll go around with another flower, and this is how it looks on the other side. I'm taking another flower, inserting you into another space, good side facing good side, and we are working on wrong side, and three, one, two, three. You can go with two, I will go with three. Okay, this is wrong side. Okay, taking another flower, and we'll connect like this. We should have six flowers around connected. These are in hexagon shape. One, two, three. And connect them like this. We need, I have four, few more. I'll go with this. This is really dark. Okay. One, two, three. And then one more. I'll go with green. Three times. One, two, three. And this is how it will look connected. So now we should go, and we can, well, we can snip off this and start with another yellow, or go with the same yellow. And I will go with the same yellow, with the same, so we have six flowers around. This is wrong side, this is good. Two, three, four, five, six. Each should have again six flowers around, and now I'll connect these two into that space, into this flower's space 3 times. 1, 2, 3. So now I should connect that blue. So grabbing another flower, this and that, good side in a middle 3 times. 1, 2, and 3. Get green here. So connect like this into one piece. 1, 2, and 3. And in other tutorials, other videos, I will show other ways how to connect them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. One more. There are other ways to connect, and I will show in other tutorials. That just make sure you have subscribed and have the notifications, have that, ring that bell, and you'll receive notifications. Looks nice. I like that way, that yellow looks very nice. And just go like this. So now we'll connect. Okay, we need, we have 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So now this should go with that. These 2. Should go like this. 1, 2, and 3. Looks amazing. Love it. Guys, thank you so much. Please subscribe. I'll see you in my next tutorial. Bye-bye.